Free now forever. Lord, we just welcome you in this place today, Father God. We thank you for this season. We thank you for the season that we're walking into. And we are so grateful and thankful for all that you are and all that you're doing in this house and all that you're doing in our homes, God. God, we just worship you and honor you this morning, and we just want to welcome you into our worship. flow as one river. Our worship, our individual worship, are the streams. And when they come together, that's that massive rushing river. So let's just lift up all of our streams of worship, because that is what washes away the brokenness of this body. So we just lift that up to you, Jesus. We lift up our streams of worship, Father God.
Put off all my heaviness, put on this garment of praise. As you turn the morning into dancing, you turn the night into day. I put off all my heaviness, and I put on this garment of praise. As you turn my morning into dancing, you turn. Darkest night.
to tell you, hallelujah, let's just make a declaration. Let's just declare, Lord, I want more. I want more of you. I want more of your presence. I want more of your glory. I want more of your spirit active in my life. Lord, we want more, 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 more. For you, we have not even begun to scratch the surface of his goodness and all that he has for our lives, for your life, for this place, for his purpose through you. Amen. Turn to somebody, give them a high five, and tell them he has more for you. Amen. Then you can be seated. Praise the Lord. And how many of you know today's a special day? Anybody know what today is? It's Veterans Day. And so we want to honor all of our veterans among us today. So we're going to share a video with you to begin that. So let's partake.
I'm staring out into the night, trying to hide the pain. To the place where love and feeling good don't ever cost a thing. And the pain you feel's a different kind of pain. I'm not running from
I don't know about you, but I'm a wreck after that. We do want to say welcome home to all of our veterans and say thank you for your service. I'm going to invite you guys to stand, all you men and women, all of our veterans, please stand and let us welcome you home. We thank you. And for those that served in Vietnam in particular, we say welcome home because you did not get a proper welcome home when you return. And I think we have a couple of pictures of one, our highest ranked veteran among us, including his service in Vietnam. This is a picture of Billy Dykus when 1971 in Vietnam. And we say thank you in particular to Billy Dykus and your service and welcome home. He wouldn't have allowed me to do that if he knew it was coming. So praise the Lord. His son ratted him out and posted it on Facebook and we found it. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yes. Naomi Spradlin's coming to share announcements with us now. Give Naomi a big hand.
Good morning, Abbey Church. If I have not had the pleasure of meeting you, I am Naomi Spradlin. I work for Pastors Paul and Perry Ann as their executive assistant since sometime in July. So I'm doing the announcements this morning, and now that you all know me, if you didn't, I would like to give a special shout out to my father, who's here today, pastor of the Move Church in Gretna, Landon Spradlin. Woo-hoo! If you haven't met him yet, you should, online, on his album. It's really great. So the first announcement today, Lauren and Aaron, if you guys would go ahead and start passing out. Pastor Perry Ann mentioned last week we're going to do the thankful sheets for Thanksgiving so that I can put them in a PowerPoint and we can have them scrolling. It's really important that we all take a moment to say what we're thankful for. And I don't know about you, but when I see what someone else is thankful for, it really makes me have more understanding of that person and be able to identify and be grateful myself about what I am grateful for. So Lauren and Aaron Schillings are passing out the thankful sheets now. If you wouldn't mind filling them out, we have a crate at the Welcome Center where you can drop them after service. It's going to be a lot of fun. Speaking of fun, on December 16th, we also have a night of Christmas music with Paul Gehring. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be really amazing from 6 to 8 p.m. It's also featuring Jesse Spradlin. I didn't hear of her until last week, and then I looked her up online, and she's pretty cool, too. And the as Aaron and Lauren are passing out the thankful sign-up sheets, we tried a new thing this year with the Abbey Church, which is we tried to do sign-ups online, and it went okay, but now we are going to say, okay, next week is the Thanksgiving dinner, and we still have quite a few empty spots. So Alyssa, Jesse, and Cassandra are now going to pass out the Thanksgiving sign-up clipboards that you know so well. If you sign up the way we're doing it this year, we will be inputting them into the system, so we need your email address when you sign up, and you'll get a reminder email like a day or two beforehand. I personally find that very helpful, so just make sure to add your email address when you sign up for what you want to bring. Yeah, that's everything. Here is Pastor Perry Ann for the offering.
Give her a hand. Come on. We appreciate all things Spradlin. I just think how great for you to be here. We're just so blessed by the DNA. Wow. Listen, last week we had the most amazing 30th anniversary in ministry celebration. Thank you, Jerry. Paul and I, it was like Ephesians 3:20 blown away. You guys, everything. I mean, there was so much detail, so much behind the scenes work. There are no words for how much appreciation we have. Our hearts are so full, so many cards, so many expressions. And listen, can I just let you on a little secret? When you've been doing this for 30 years, both of us, it's hard to come to church not knowing what's going to be done to you. Like, listen, pastoring you, I love you all. It has delivered me from a lot of the need for control, as has parenting. But last Sunday, I was lost to know what to do with myself, and it couldn't have been better. It couldn't have been better. I sat right there, and it was like the church spoke back into us, who they see us to be. And I just want to tell you, you did a kingdom thing. You don't walk around thinking, please appreciate me, or you wouldn't have done it 30 years. But when the way you guys expressed that with your gifts, with your love, with every little detail of it, it ministers to a pastor's heart. And I kept thinking last week, I kept thinking I wanted to go, we're not leaving or dying. But, you know, they say do that stuff before that time. And so you guys participated in it. So my passion is that we set something off that will continue for each other. Speaking of that whole experience, I want to testify. We had sunny morning, sunny night, but for Paul and I, the 30th anniversary celebration extended into Monday when we were hosted by Larry and Amber Lavelle to our first ever Cowboys football game. He is waving the tray in the air. So Paul and Jeff are modeling. What happened was, let me tell you something about, all right, if you got that out of your system, I'll move on. Anyway, I have a shirt too. Donna does too. I'm not wearing it because I wore it all week long. But here's the thing about Larry and Amber, and here's what I caught from them. They didn't just want to buy us tickets and get us there. They wanted us to have the experience. For Larry and Amber Lavelle, a Cowboy game is not an event. It is an experience. So we had gourmet, low-carb, borderline keto tailgating. I mean, I'm gourmet. They had more food at their truck than I have on a meal. But you knew that because Dwayne ratted me out. Anyway, if you were here Sunday night, it was amazing. And then Amber very sweetly says to me and Donna, if y'all need to go to the restroom, let's go do that now, and I'll show you the pro shop. And so she takes me in the pro shop. You need to know the only cowboy gear that I owned in my life came from Walmart, not the pro shop. So I'm in the pro shop, and I'm like, whoa. And then she reveals she had an agenda. She was in there to get us to pick out shirts for ourselves and for our husbands. So that's what these were, you know. I mean, I was like, please, Amber, save yourself. But she bought us the T-shirt. And you know what? That means something. Can I just share with you, God wants you to get the T-shirt, too, from the experience he has for you. I want to tell you, that's how God is. They modeled kingdom for us on a Monday night when they didn't have to. They didn't just give us an event. They gave us an experience. It was fantastic, every bit of it. But then there are seeds of faith to sow into us, and it really was seeds. Listen, if you are religious, you won't think a seed could be a Cowboys ticket. You'll think it has to be something that feeds the poor somewhere. But I want to tell you, a seed is whatever God puts on your heart to sow into somebody's life. So how many of you have heard a little rumor that we've had our house up for sale for a while? I've been lighting candles for a while. I can't find things in my house because it's all put away. Our house has been up for sale. It's been a roller coaster of a ride. And then guess what? We've lived in that house 15 years. So guess what? Can you believe it? The buyer had a list of repairs. Can you believe it? There were things wrong with that house. We did not know. We had just lived in it. So all the roller coaster of it, we did find a house that on the 30th anniversary Sunday, the morning of, I felt the confirmation of the Lord, that's the house. Go for it. But not until then, because our head had been all over the place, just praying, just waiting on the Lord. Even when you're prophetic, I'm so like, boom, hear it. But even when you're prophetic, sometimes it's a process to hear God. And those are the hard ones because you're used to the pow, the boom. So we were waiting on the Lord. So Kay Rollins was here. Our realtor was here. Our wonderful realtor was here all day. And I went up to her at the 30th thing and I said, we're going to go for that house that night. So, like, I'm living in all the worlds at one time. So we're sitting there in the second quarter. We've already had our shirts purchased. I'm sitting there in a world-class event, in a world-class stadium. I'm just sitting here going, Lord, this is enough. This is enough. I've arrived. This is the best. And all of a sudden, my phone lights up, and it's Kay saying they've accepted your offer on repairs. It's done. In other words, the contract moved from option period to pending while we're sitting there in the second quarter. And then she said, we'll know tomorrow about the offer you put in on your house. And I was like, wow. I turned and told Larry and Amber. I rejoiced. Then literally 3 minutes later, she said, we just heard back they accepted your offer. Like the whole thing happened in the second quarter. And that's when they were really winning too. It was like, it was incredible. But here's the deal. Kay was on the other end working doggone hard. She spent 3 hours to make sure we wouldn't be homeless for an interim period. She worked three, the while we were at the Cowboy game, she was doing her real estate stuff, trying to keep her pastors from being 3 days in the street. I would have gone to a bed and breakfast. But hey, anyway, what I'm marveling at this morning is you guys, please believe me, I'm fresh off this experience and it's so real to me. God wants to treat you to a dose of his world, not just an event of his, here's a little handful, but a dose of his world. And while you're sitting there in the stands, taking it in, the Holy Spirit is working for you. Can you believe we serve a God who wants to work for you? We get so hung up in working for him, and we want to work for him. We want to do. We want to serve. That's the product of the love in our heart. But Kay, the last thing she texted me that night as I was sitting there sharing with them, and I turned to them and I said, who would believe the seeds you planted would go off in this way to provide us a night to just sit back and realize after 30 years, you know the old joke about there's this pastor that, this is not us, but there are moments. There's this pastor that went down the train station every morning. Every morning he went down the train station, and somebody finally said, why do you do that? And he said, I just like to go watch something I don't have to push. So we don't believe that. That's not how we pastor. But after 30 years, you might have felt that way in a minute, and for a minute. And I just declare to you, the fruit of our lives is for you too. So we sat there receiving a gift, an incredible cosmic learning event. I mean, you should see me. I'm like, oh, everything about the stadium, you know. I kept watching the screen, this biggest screen in the world. I was like, I would just go, whoa, look at that screen. How many pixels are in that screen? And then I would be like, oh, wait, the real people are down there. Then Larry actually handed me the binoculars, and his binoculars didn't come from Walmart either. Well, maybe they did. I guess Walmart has good, I don't think. Anyway, like, then I found the binoculars, and it was like when I found snorkeling. I was like, they couldn't get them away from me. I was living deep in the experience. I really want you to hear this. God is inviting you to live deep in his experience. It's got all kinds of things for you to look at and take in, and he wants to host you to the pro shop. I love Walmart. I thank God for Walmart, but sometimes you need to know you're worthy of the pro shop. And while he's doing that, some of the things you've struggled with, like we've been waiting on contracts to go through. Who would know? While we're sitting there having an experience, God works out the details of your life. And suddenly, Larry and Amber were the first to say it. It became about more than a Cowboy game. And that's saying a lot. Am I saying it good? Yeah, go ahead. Isn't that awesome? Yeah.
Backside of this story, because I didn't know about season tickets and how they work. Larry said something from, I think it was you that did offering last week, about the cost and the real cost of the deal. Larry was telling me these season tickets, I've never been to a game, so I went when they had that little place over there in Irving with a hole in the top, and somebody gave me a season ticket. I had no idea what they're worth. He was telling me, he said, this is like a ministry. He said, this seat, he said, I can put these on StubHub. You got to understand something. He said, there's a cost, and then there's a real benefit of what this thing's worth. And he said, I bought the ticket for $135. He said, I can put them on StubHub and sell them for $250. He said, but my investment is going to be way bigger than that $250. Hey. I think you're seeing the investment this morning. Do you comprehend this? It's magnitude compound. And for him to leave happy after they lost, that was a miracle in itself. But it was one of the best nights that, I'm not a fan of Nike, but that's another whole story. But I love this shirt and what it means to me that we went through the experience with Paul and Perry. We got hit on the way home. I got hit in Donna's car on the way home. That was another story. Then found out 2 days later that she's uninsured, but God had his hand in something because she's an Uber driver, and her Uber was active, and they have to cover it. So there's always a lining behind. It's what are you focused on, and what's the cost, and what's the real benefit?
That's right.
It's huge.
That's right.
You guys, you don't know what you did monumentally for us Monday night. Thank you.
Who would think, your pastor is having a story about a cowboy game would have something to do with you, but it does because we're family. And that was the whole point that Larry said. It was like the experience of kingdom relationship trumped everything else. What was so cool when Jeff, because, you know, listen, somebody may need to hear this. I was thinking about that accident. We were pulling out of the parking lot, and this driver sideswiped their car. And I was thinking, man, that's so much like the devil. You've had this amazing night, and something comes to try to go, uh-uh. And she kind of was not saying it was her fault when it was. And guess what? A policeman walked up right there and said, I saw it all. He was right there. He saw the whole thing. So he wrote a report. And, you know, it was just, listen, we can't go under for going over, guys, if we keep giving. So I say that to encourage you, but also for you to jump on where we're living. You've prayed with us. You've stood with us. Let's all jump on this breakthrough time together for whatever it is. So we're going to pray over our offering. Giving is a way of life. Open-handed living is what we've been talking about. It's a choice every time. But my goodness, the choice gets so much more fun along the way. And so I just pray, Lord, right now for anybody here who just needed this word of encouragement. Maybe some of you need to remember that God wants to give you an experience of his provision, not an event of his meeting one need. And so, Father, we pray for that right now, for people to have a revelation that goes off inside them that lives beyond one event but becomes an experience. And, Father, we thank you for every gift given in the 30th anniversary. We thank you that this church rallied around something. And Lord, I declare it's the first of many things in this new season that we're going to rally around. But Father, the hallmark of them all is that your hand's on them. So we just look to you. We lay aside our notions of lack. We lay aside our notions of not being worthy. And we realize that you purchased it all on the cross. And you are a giver. So our worthiness is changed. We were changed from unworthy to worthy. But even more than that, it's about you and your heart and your provision. And we don't want to leave one gift coming behind. So I just declare over everyone who's waiting and frustrated, who it's drawn out long, I just declare in the spirit right now for you, hear these words, there's a second quarter. For you, there's a second quarter. There's a second quarter. And everything that's been delayed, I declare, is not delayed anymore because of the seeds planted and the corporate faith. And this breakthrough is your breakthrough. So jump on it with your heart right now as we pray. And then when you've done that, giving comes naturally. Amen. So we have ways to give up on the screen. We have baskets, and you just exercise your faith, most importantly, in all of that. And we're going to go ahead and dismiss the older kids to their class at this time.